Let me welcome all of you and thank you for being here this morning.
Our action to provide emergency relief is needed now more than ever before. The people need to know that we are not going to leave until we get something accomplished.
We recognize that families all across America are struggling, that businesses are closing, that hospitals are overwhelmed. As we deal with this second wave or third wave of this pandemic, it is absolutely essential that we pass emergency relief.
There's been a lot of enormously good give and take. I came to this with the notion that I'm hearing from Virginians, somebody used it and I borrowed their term, that it would be stupidity on steroids if Congress left for Christmas without doing an interim package as a bridge.
I happen to be a deficit hawk. I don't like borrowing money. I don't like spending money we don't have. But the time to borrow money, maybe the only time to borrow money is when there's a crisis. And this is a crisis. We want to help people at this particular time. And so we've come together and we've been very careful. This is not a $1.8 trillion stimulus bill. This is a relief measure, half that amount.
We've hit a spot where we know that can give us emergency relief. That's all this is about. Emergency relief going through the first quarter, which ends on April 1. President-elect Biden will be coming in. He'll be able to determine if there's more that needs to be done. This is an emergency that gets us through from this holiday season, people that are losing in December, and we just can't leave without that being addressed.
Stories that we've gone over. We'll be working diligently now to put
the biggest stories the moment they happen from around the globe. Subscribe to Bloomberg Quick Take now for insight in an instant.